Thank you very much, everybody, for joining us at the kickoff. My name is Ellie. This is such a special moment for all of us because this is the first ever Animal Advocacy Conference Asia, focusing on the animal justice movement, specifically in Asia. So our team is over 30 volunteers from different countries and regions in Asia, and we have worked really hard together to organize this conference. And it really means so much for us that you're all here with us to celebrate the kickoff with us.
Thank you, Ellie, for starting. My name's Angel, and I know it would have been even better for us if we're all in one place, and we originally wanted to hold AACA offline, but because of the pandemic, we made the decision to offer it online this year. And actually, we are quite excited for this opportunity because now we are here with all of you, some of whom might not have been able to take a few days off and travel. So with this new format, we feel that we are probably connected with even more of you in Asia.
Hi, I'm Alia. I'm the country rep for Pakistan. So while we're waiting for some more people to enter, we thought we'd like to go through some housekeeping rules. Please be aware that most of our workshops, including this assembly, will be recorded. Recordings of all our sessions will be available after the conference on YouTube. Please turn off your camera if you don't want your face recorded, but we encourage everyone to keep it on otherwise, so we can enjoy community spirit with all of you and all the vegans and activists out there who are although far away, but close to us. Thank you.
Now, please take a moment to rename yourself. You can do this by hovering over your thumbnail on your device and by clicking the three dots next to your name. So please have your name, the country you're based in, your organization that you're affiliated with, if applicable, and your pronouns. Again, that's first about your name, your country that you're based in, organization you're affiliated with, and your pronouns. You'll be asked to rename yourself this way for our workshops during the next 2 weeks. If you're not familiar with what pronouns are, they are, for example, she, her, he, him, or they, them, that you identify yourself with. We ask you to do this as part of keeping this a safe space for everyone. We welcome people of all genders, and this way we will know how to refer to other people without assuming. And also, please keep yourself muted for this particular session.
We strive to keep this a safe space for everybody. And to achieve that, we do have a code of conduct. So if Charles could share that link with everybody in the chat, that's the code of conduct for the conference. This applies to everybody, including all the attendees, the speakers, and us, the team. So please go through them so you're aware of what they are. And anyone who violates the code of conduct will be warned and removed from Zoom sessions. And any participants who attempt to share files or speak up without being asked to will also be ejected from the Zoom room.
Hi, everybody. My name is Kaho, and I'm a country representative for Team Japan. And this year, we have invited activists and organizations whose campaigns and approaches are different from one another. So a variety of ideas and views will be shared throughout the conference. I want to emphasize here that views expressed by our speakers and AACA volunteers are of their own and not necessarily those of Animal Alliance Asia as an organization. Now I want to introduce a hand signal. Since all the talks and workshops will be online, it's difficult for the speakers to see the reaction of the audience. So throughout the conference, we want to encourage the participants to use this hand signal. You can see me. Jazz hands to show your agreement or excitement for what's being shared or discussed. It's quite encouraging for speakers to be able to see such reactions from everybody. So let's practice this jazz hands now. So who's excited for the conference? Great, awesome. Everybody's excited. We encourage everyone to do this throughout the conference.
Thank you, Kaho. As part of our effort to make AACA more accessible for more people, we are offering Chinese live captions, subtitles for some of our sessions. I'm going to explain how that works in Chinese, so please give me just 1 second. 为了让更多的朋友可以参加这个会议，我们会为部分的环节提供中文字幕。大家可以参考我们网站上的中文议程，在上面的时间表会有CC的标注。 因为我们的资源有限，所以呢，我们今年没有办法把所有的演讲都加中文字幕，所以真的很抱歉。但是我们还是希望大家会尽量参与我们的会议。Thank you.
Before we start, we'd like you to join us in taking a minute to remember why we're all here in the first place. Please find a comfortable position and close your eyes if you feel comfortable in doing so. Let's take a minute silence. We remember those who are born in captivity and cruelty.
我们记得那些一出生就被囚禁、被残忍对待的动物。
We remember those who are oppressed under speciesism.
我们记得那些受到物种歧视压迫的动物。
We remember those who share this planet with us.
我们记得跟我们共享这个星球的动物。
We are here in solidarity for those who want to live in freedom.
我们为那些希望自由生活的动物团结一致。
We are here in solidarity for those whose voices are ignored even when they resist.
我们为那些即使反抗声音也被忽略的动物团结一致。
We come together for a better world for all.
我们团结在一起为所有生灵创造更美好的世界。
You may open your eyes now, and thank you very much.
Okay, thank you very much, Alia. So now let me introduce our music performer, Erica. She's a vegan musician from Japan, and she's actually written a special song for this conference. So over to you, Erica.
Thank you so much. Can you guys just wave if you can hear me? Okay, great. This is my song, Vegan. Okay. Just think if you like it too, put yourself in their shoes. Their fear is real, their ordeal is undeniable. If you don't like to hear their screams while you eat them, you could be vegan. There's no personal choice when you're just dream of being a rescue. they're still on the menu. What did they ever say to you? This speciesism needs to be solved.
Thank you so much, Erica, for a beautiful performance. Let's all give her a nice virtual hooray. Now, coming back, so within our animal justice movement, a lot of ideas, tactics, strategies are being applied internationally that are based and that has worked mostly in the Western culture. They have shaped and contributed tremendously to the cause of animal justice worldwide. At the same time, we feel that the voices and experiences of Asian animal justice activists are not being listened to.
Western approaches, or approaches that are more dominant, that originate from the West, do not always work as well in Asian countries because of differences in culture, religion, language, history, political context, etc. So Asian activists and the organizations face different challenges from the West or other parts of the world. We've seen it happen firsthand in different parts of Asia, and we see the need to focus on Asia-specific challenges.
We have organized this conference with the aim of developing a forum where activists across Asia can get together, learn from each other, and build a stronger and more sustainable animal justice movement across Asia. Many large scale international organizations are now focusing more on Asia. Let's build this momentum from within and take the lead in growing our movement.
So as Carol mentioned earlier at the kickoff, as a conference, we will keep a neutral stance within the spectrum of different approaches within the movement. And we hope that the participants themselves can discover and appreciate different approaches and find something that they think would be relevant and effective in their own circumstances. To keep our conference a safe space for everybody as much as possible, we do have four core values, and we'd like to share them with you here. Please bear them in mind to guide us and you throughout the conference, including our interactions with each other and with the speakers. The first one is anti-speciesism and anti-oppression. And we stand against all forms of oppression. Number two is nonviolence. We commit to nonviolence in our actions and communications. Number three, inclusivity. We welcome all people, but not all behaviors. Number four, we are open to change and learning. We do accept that we always have room to learn and improve. So these are the four core values that we have as an organization and for the conference. Now we'd like to share a link to our timetable for the next 2 weeks. So Charles, if you could share that link in the chat. This is where you can find the timetable for the next 2 weeks. Please note that all the workshop times are in Japan Standard Time. So please don't forget to calculate the time difference so you won't miss the workshops. Summary of each talk can be found on our website, in our newsletters, and social media posts. So I think Charles will now share all of our social media platforms in the chat.
Thank you so much, Ellie. Next up, we have two project announcements. First, we have Jamie Harris from the UK. He's representing Animal Advocacy Careers. So Jamie, if you could start sharing your screen, that would be amazing.
Perfect. All right, thanks. Yeah, I'll get cracking in. Yeah, thanks. for being here and your interest in helping animals. It's really great, and great to see so many people here. Yes, so my co-founder and researcher at Animal Advocacy Careers, another nonprofit called Centers Institute, we're a teacher. Because I sort of looked at what most people look for when that were conventional, that other people have done, and I looked at the results of your work directly. You know, you interact with the students, you can see how they improve, that sort of thing. And it was okay. But my plans completely changed when I heard about the idea of replaceability. And this is one of the concepts we've written up on a page on our website called the Glossary of Terms. But this idea of replaceability is basically that if you didn't take the job or career path you're considering, what would happen otherwise? And in the case of teaching, somebody else, quite competent probably, maybe quite similar to me, would have got the job. So I'm only really adding to the career of teaching what I'm adding over and above what the next best candidate for the role would have done. And it's a pretty complicated thing. Like, there's lots of indirect effects that I'm not taking into consideration here. I'm sort of summarizing it. But yeah, I found that that changed my view quite a lot. And there are various considerations like this that can affect your career strategy, how you think about doing good in the world, how you think about how your career can progress. So I started looking for other ways to contribute and to do good in the world. I donated 10% of my salary for a couple of years, but unfortunately, when you're a teacher, you don't earn a huge amount of money. So I wasn't able to donate that much to animal advocacy organizations. So I also started volunteering for various different organizations, but unfortunately, as a teacher, you don't have a huge amount of time. So that wasn't a particularly great way for me to be able to do good in the world either. So I did some reevaluating and some planning, and I thought about my strengths and what I could contribute that others wouldn't be able to contribute so well. And I did end up working in the animal advocacy movement directly in nonprofits. But there are lots of other ways that you can help animals over the course of your career that don't necessarily involve working in nonprofits. You can work in direct care for animals, certainly helping animals directly. You could also work in food companies, helping people to transition away from animal foods and helping animals in that way. You could also potentially work in government and policy, because this has a massive influence over people's behavior and the lifestyles that people are able to lead. You could work in advocacy more directly, as I say, nonprofits or volunteering, that sort of thing. You could also work in research, such as in academia, working at a university, that sort of thing. There's various ways that can lead to impact for animals. And you could also try and earn more money and donate that money to help animal advocacy nonprofits. And I guess there's all these different pathways and all these options and ideas about career strategy, how you can think about your career, how you can help animals, could be a bit confusing. So to help talk it through with you, we offer a free one-to-one careers advising call service. And based on our research and experience from our advising call so far, we'll be able to advise you about career paths that help you and that help animals. The call is completely focused on your needs, whether that's listing possible options that you might not have considered yet, or drawing up a detailed plan of next steps and how to explore the options that are on the table already. The application form for the Careers Advice Call service takes about, well, you can do it quite thoroughly and use it as a useful planning process in itself, or you can do it quite quickly in about 10 minutes. And other than that, no particular preparation is needed. Just bring your ideas and questions as they are. The deadline for the applications for this one-to-one Careers Advising Call service is Sunday the 6th of December. And we're not currently sure if we'll ever offer this service again. So this may be your last chance to apply. So I'd strongly encourage you to apply. Okay, so we do have some other services that I'll just mention very briefly. You can have a look at them on our website, have a bit of an explore. We have information about different sorts of career paths in animal advocacy, and particular interest perhaps is one of our skills profiles, which is entitled Growing the Animal Advocacy Community in Countries Where It Is Small or New. So again, you can find those on our website. We also have an online course. Some people are doing the online course now. We had about 18 applications for that again in December. But mainly, I encourage you to sign up for our one-to-one careers advising call. I look forward to speaking to you and seeing some of your applications. That'd be great. If you've got spare time during the conference, maybe in between sessions or something like that, you could apply during the conference itself, or you could do it soon. But don't forget, and definitely don't miss the deadline, which, as I said, is Sunday the 6th of December. We're definitely not experts in any particular Asian country or anything like that, but we can hopefully talk through some more general considerations and be a bit of a sounding board for you to share your ideas and for us to reflect and give advice in that sense. So I'll share the link in the chat to the application for the one-to-one careers advising. But yeah, thanks so much. Thanks for having me, and look forward to hearing from some of you, and hope you enjoy the rest of the conference.
Thank you so much, Jamie. And yes, if you could please share all the relevant links in the chat box, that would be really helpful. It sounds like a very exciting project, and I'm sure you and your team will offer very useful insights to all of us, no matter where we are. Okay.
Thanks so much.
Thank you. And then next up, we have an announcement from Jessica Alpha from ProVeg International. Now, Jessica won't be joining us live today, so we will play a clip that she has prepared for us. So Charles, if you could do that, please.
Hey everyone, so thanks for joining me today. Today I'm going to talk to you about the ProVeg Grants Program and describe a bit about how the ProVeg Grants Program can support you in your vegan advocacy and meat reduction work. So hello, I'm Jessica Ava. I'm the Grants Program Director for ProVeg International. Here's all of my contact information, so you're most welcome to contact me after the conference, or anytime. So to give a bit of background about ProVeg, so the mission of our organization is to reduce the global consumption of animals by 50% by the year 2040. And we do this through a variety of tactics and interventions and partnerships. And one way that we do this is by supporting international groups across the world to strengthen their advocacy tactics and also expand their advocacy tactics. And we do this with our ProVeg Grants Program. So the aim of the ProVeg Grants Program is to empower you to create a vegan world. And we have two methods that we use. We have financial grants, and then we also have our intervention accelerators, and I'll talk about each of these in a bit of detail there. So first we have our financial grants. And so these grants range from 500 up to 30,000 US dollars, and they're for any type of vegan advocacy or meat reduction efforts. So essentially any type of work that is reducing the demand for animal products, or in some way working towards the elimination of animals from the food system. So any of this type of work is eligible for our grants. Welfare campaigns aren't eligible, but diet change work, food policy work is certainly eligible. So if you would like to apply for a grant, and I hope that you do, here's the website, proveggrants.org/grants, and there you will find all of the specific criteria and the application process and all of the details. And next we have our accelerators. So the accelerators aim to equip you with all of the skills and all of the tools that you need to manage an effective organization and to build a strong campaign. So we have a few different accelerators. The first one is our nonprofit management accelerator. And within this accelerator, each month we focus on a different nonprofit management topic. And we're catering towards organizations that work specifically within the animal and vegan space. So all of our topics are focused more on the needs of organizations that are in the animal and vegan space. And we also cater towards more of the emerging groups, grassroots groups, and mid-sized groups. And then in addition to the nonprofit management accelerator, we also have intervention accelerators. And we have a few of these. And each of our intervention accelerators will provide you with all of the skills and knowledge that you need to develop a certain type of intervention and to replicate that intervention in your own country. And all of our accelerators, they provide expert-led training webinars, one-on-one consultation support, so you can get support in developing your strategy or building your strategic plan. And then we also have campaign guides, evaluation templates, and a lot more too. So if you would like more information about either our grants or accelerators, here's our website. And I would encourage you to go there to apply and get all the details. And then of course, here's my contact information. So you're most welcome to reach out to me at any point, or you can set up a meeting with me and we can discuss a bit more about your work and how we can support your work. You can contact me by email or WhatsApp or WeChat, whatever is most convenient for you. And then I just wanted to leave you with this map, So this map shows just a few of our grant recipients. This is maybe about 25% of our grant recipients. And I wanted to say that I hope one day I am able to see your logo on this map as well. So I encourage you to apply for one of our grants or join one of our accelerators, and hopefully one day you'll be joining our team. So thank you very much for all of your time. And again, here's my contact information. So I'm wishing you a very productive conference, and I look forward to speaking to you soon. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Jamie, to introduce Animal Advocacy Careers, and Jessica to introduce ProVeg International. Those grants are super important for those who have already started their movements or who are thinking of starting a new movement to expand their activism and build more effective activism. So now we want to take a group photo, and we want to post these photos on our social media. So if you don't want your faces to be on our social media platforms, then please cover your screen like this, or turn off your camera. So if you turn off your camera, we can still see your names. But if you don't want your names to be seen on the social media, then we can cover your names. You can cover your names when we post the photos, if that makes sense. So only those who want to be featured on their social media in a photo, please stay your cameras turned on. And we have five galleries, I think. And we can only take separate screenshots. So we will take five screenshots, and everybody has a different variety, different combinations of faces. So we don't know which screenshot you're going to be in. So please stay, keep smiling in all the five screenshots. Okay, so I think Charles, you will be taking the screenshot. So
so everyone, please just look front of the camera, and I'm doing it now. I have three pages, and the first one is done. Please give me some time, and thank you. Okay, I'm doing the second one now. Great, and the last one. Just a moment. Okay, super.
Awesome, thank you, Charles. So in case you change your mind and you don't want your faces to be featured in our photos, then please message us on our social media or the info@animaladvocacyconferenceasia.com. That's our email. So is that correct? It's being shared in the chat. Thank you, Angel. So if you change your mind, and please send us a message, and we will cover your face. Now we want to introduce our next musician, Aditi. So please welcome Aditi and enjoy her music.
Thank you. Thank you so much. So I'm Aditi, and I'm from India. And the song that I'm going to sing is Blowing in the Wind by Bob Dylan. Thank you so much.
How many roads has the man walked down before you call him a man? How many seas must a white dove say before she sleeps in the sand? How many times must a cannonball fly
exist for their love to be free. How many times can a man turn his head, pretending he just doesn't see? The answer, my friend, is blowing in the wind. The answer is
much, Aditi, for sharing your music. You sounded so beautiful. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Aditi and Kaho. Okay, so I think we're coming to an end of the kickoff assembly. Just wanted to say thank you again so much for sharing this special moment with us, the team. We hope you enjoyed celebrating the start of AACA with us. And we hope you're excited for the workshops for the next 2 weeks. Our first workshop by Ryuji Chua will be starting in about 20 minutes, 8 p.m. Japan Standard Time. And this Zoom room will be open until then. So if you're attending, I hope you are. If you're attending the workshop, please, you can actually stay in the room and mute yourself and turn your camera off, or you can come back at 8 p.m. Japan time. And yes, we would like to thank our tech coordinator, Charles, for helping us run this kickoff smoothly. Thank you so much, Charles. And thank you everyone for staying until the end. We will see you in about 20 minutes again. Thank you.